The first worm was designed by Robert Morris, Jr. in 1988. The worm itself had no malicious payload, but it ended up bogging down the machines that it infected by spawning new processes uncontrollably and exhausting resources. At the time it was released, it affected 10% of all internet hosts. It spread through three different propagation vectors. The worm tried to crack passwords using a small dictionary and a publicly readable password file, and also targeted hosts that were already listed in a trusted host file on the machine that was already infected. This ability to perform remote execution was one way that the worm was allowed to spread. The second way that it spread was in a buffer overflow vulnerability in the finger daemon. This was a standard buffer overflow exploit, and if you don't know about buffer overflows, I would urge you to take a computer security course. But essentially, this is a very common attack that makes remote exploits possible, effectively resulting in the ability to run arbitrary code at the root level privilege. The third way that the worm spread was via the debug command in sendmail, which is a mail sending service. In early sendmail versions, it was possible to execute a command on a remote machine by sending an SMTP message. The worm used this capability to spread automatically. A key theme that we'll see in the design of other worms is this use of multiple vectors. Now, any particular worm may end up using a different set of vectors depending on the remote vulnerabilities that it's trying to exploit. But the idea that any worm should be able to exploit multiple weaknesses in a system gives it more ways to spread and often also speeds up the propagation of the worm. This worm design also followed the following general approach, which we see showing up over and over again in worm designs. First, the worm needs to scan other hosts to find potentially vulnerable hosts. In the second step, it needs to spread by infecting other vulnerable hosts. And in the third step, it needs to remain undiscoverable and undiscovered so that it can continue to operate and spread without being removed from systems.